Hey everybody, welcome to BuraTech. In this episode, we're going to be asking the question, is it worthwhile to learn to code in 2019? Welcome back. We're in the middle of 2019 and maybe it was your New Year's resolution to learn to code. I'm not here to judge if you haven't started already. So should you learn to code in 2019? Chances are you've been hearing the phrase, you need to learn to code, for years and years now. And as a coder myself, I love coding. You can't tell me twice to look up a YouTube video, to take an online course, or to just simply start coding. I love it, but not everybody does. So over the years, we've heard time and time again that if you learn to code, you'll probably make more money. And this is generally true. But should you do it, and is it still worthwhile in 2019? Well, the answer, of course, is yes, but there's a lot of asterisks around that yes. In this video, we're going to be talking about people who have never coded before, but we're also going to be talking about people who have tried coding before and maybe didn't work out, or if you're already a coder and you need to make a better move in your career. So let's talk about the broad implications of learning to code and why it has been ingrained in media outlets for the last few years. If you want a career, you have to have a career that is in demand. And when it comes to any kind of job market, just like any market, there's supply and demand. Now with coders, there's only a certain amount of the population who can really do a good job. Hence, the supply is somewhat limited. Now, not everyone can learn to code. Some people are just not going to be coders. And if you're one of these people, that's okay. Because one of the things about learning to code is that you want to find out if it's right for you or if it's not right for you. And if it's not right for you, there are a ton of other jobs for you out there. But if you do, let's say, crosswords or Sudoku and you like solving problems, then chances are coding might be a great career switch for you. So when it comes down to it, the whole learn to code movement, there is less supply of this particular job and it pays pretty well. So if you're good enough to do it, then maybe you should. Now this comes down to whether you want your career to be good or not. Now there's a difference between jobs and careers. Careers take much more management and they take much more work than simple jobs. A job is, for example, mowing somebody's lawn or washing dishes at a restaurant. A career, on the other hand, is becoming proficient at a craft and selling your skills to the world. There's a big difference. Now, overall, not everyone is gonna have a career. Some people just need jobs. And this is not necessarily a bad thing. If you just like going to work, getting paid, and doing something, then maybe a job is right for you. But if you want something really more out of your life, then a career is probably the path you wanna take. Now, technology is an amazing career path to take. And let's say you've gone to school and you didn't get a computer science degree or a computer engineering degree or anything remotely technical, but you still want to learn to code. Well, you can definitely do that because there's a lot of people out there, specifically older people, who went and got maybe a philosophy degree, an English degree, and they're really smart, but there's no jobs in those degrees, so they become coders. In fact, I know a lot of people personally who have these degrees, and they're amazing coders. They're, in fact, some of the best coders I know. The 2008 financial crisis reset a lot of expectations in people's minds. Before that, there was a lot more people that entered an English degree or a philosophy degree or a humanities degree and would end up with a job. After 2008, there's been a drop in those kind of degrees because they're not as viable as they once were. Now, since this is a tech channel, a lot of people might think an English degree is not a good idea. However, I have this theory that the top 1% of any degree you want working at your company. Because if you're working at a company with nothing but coders, are those coders gonna write the email to sell your product? Of course not. You're gonna need someone who knows the English language very well, and you'll probably have to hire, again, the top 1% of an English graduate in the country. So what's happened is that while those degrees are important, they're just not as important as they once were. So if you have one of these degrees or you've never went to college and you want to learn to code, the good news is that it's never been easier to learn to code. So if you've never coded before or you've been coding, one of the best pieces of advice I've ever been given is that success is a wheel, not a destination. You can't just simply learn to code and then you're done learning to code. You constantly have to be learning to code. And this is where the career mindset is different from the job mindset. In the job mindset, you go to work, you get paid, you come home. In a career mindset, you're constantly doing work. So let's take a look at an example. Let's say you've been a web developer for 10 years and you want to maybe branch out. Well, you have to constantly be looking at other types of development environments. And there's a good reason for that. Programming is supply and demand. And what happens in technology is that there's some new technology that comes out. There's some new programming language. There's something new that comes out. And as soon as that happens, the supply is down. In fact, if something new comes out tomorrow, literally the supply is almost zero other than the people that were actually working on that technology. So a good example of this from my past is that when Swift came out, I produced an 80-hour course on how to code in Swift. And Swift is, of course, Apple's new programming language, or at least it was new at the time, that replaced the old clunky Objective-C. Because I produced this mammoth course and I made a bunch of webinars, and I also released an app with it, I made a lot of money doing this. I learned how to code in Swift very quickly, which is a skill that you need to understand. Whether you're a beginner or you've been coding for a while, you need to learn the next technology as quickly as possible. And the beautiful part about this is that once you learn how to learn quickly, then not only is your career going to be better, but you're going to make a lot more money. Because like I said, if some new technology comes out tomorrow and the supply for coders is down, then if you simply just become this good at that technology, you're going to get a job. But you want to do better than that because careers are competitive. You not only want to just do a mediocre job at the new technology, you want to do the best job possible. Now, with new technology, it's always really hard because a lot of the problems are not fleshed out. And these can be design problems, they can be coding problems, they can be technological problems. There's a ton of different problems that you have to work with. So let's say you're a web developer and you build beautiful websites. Well, if you move over to something new, let's say like virtual reality, then the new virtual reality isn't as fleshed out. Your new product isn't going to be as good as your old product because the old products have all the bugs and all the designs fleshed out. When new technology comes out, things can be clunky. But the point is that if you're a web developer and you're getting bored of it, then you can move over to something new. A good example of this is Flutter. Flutter is new and it is a complete game changer in the mobile space. I've been a mobile developer for many, many years and Flutter is absolutely amazing. In fact, Apple should come out with a competitor and I'll talk about that in another video. So how do you master new technology quickly? Well, it's quite simple. I have a video about that which you can check out right here. If you start learning online is the best way to do this because you can learn at your own pace and watch the videos faster. So if you're a beginner or an expert and you want to move up in your career or you want to get a job in the first place, how do you do it? It's a really simple answer, and that answer is to build a lot of practical projects. I always say to my students and people that want to learn to code that it has to be like an athlete. Athletes practice and then they compete. When you are a coder, you practice, make a bunch of prototypes, you rapid prototype, and then you come out with some products. Now, the funny thing about this is that the more practical projects that you add to your portfolio that look good, by the way, the better off you'll be. Now, making your portfolio look good is a story for another time, but you have to make sure that whatever your portfolio is, it's presentable and the technology is sound. Because if you come out with 5 or 6 projects in the newest technology, guaranteed you're gonna find a new job. There's also a lot of other items that make you successful in a career, such as being reliable, being punctual, and having soft skills. But again, those are stories for another time. So a lot of times people want to learn to code, and you have to understand that there is really no quick fix to this. You're going to have to spend hours of learning how to code, and you're going to have to spend hours building projects. The problem with this is that most school systems don't show you how to build products. Most school systems show you how to take tests. And there's a huge difference to building a successful application and to taking a multiple choice test. In fact, some of the tests I received as a coder when I was in high school, I got terrible marks in, and that left a huge impression on me. So coding is building. So your job as a coder is more like a construction worker rather than a sales clerk. So what's my biggest tip for people that want to learn to code today? You should code every day for 15 minutes. You all have 15 minutes, you just have to make the time. Do a little bit less Facebook, do a little bit less social media, and instead build something. Now, even if you don't build a complete project in 15 minutes because it's almost impossible, you want to try and type out code for 50 minutes a day for as long as possible. When you want to change your life, you have to get in the habit. And by just doing something every day, you start to get in the habit. And what you'll find out is that 15 minutes turns into 30, 30 minutes turns into an hour turns into 2, and if you're like me, 2 turns into 12. Now, there's been times in my life where I've literally woken up at 6 o'clock in the morning, and I've basically coded the entire day till 6 o'clock at night. You don't have to do this, but if you do that, you will be really good at coding. So one of the best ways to learn anything is to completely immerse yourself with it for the entire day. So let's recap. If you want to learn to code, you want to be in the career mindset. If you want to learn to code, if you've never coded before, you want to start doing this every day and you want to make it a habit. And if you're already a coder, you have to understand that success is a wheel, not a destination. That you always have to be learning and you always have to be improving. 2019 is as good as any year to learn to code because there will be no shortage of coders in the near future. We're a long way away from automating completely everything in the coding space. If you want to change your life and you like technology, coding might be the right career for you. Thanks for listening. I hope you had a good time listening to me talk about why you should learn to code. If you really want to learn to code, you can take Mammoth Interactive's course, which is 155 hours called Hello Coding. In Hello Coding, you get to learn everything from web development all the way to machine learning. It's more than 170 hours and you get it for life. Now a word from this video sponsor, NordVPN. If you want to keep your location private and your data encrypted, you should use NordVPN. If you use the link below and use the coupon code BURA in the checkout, you can get 75% off the 3-year plan. So why should you use NordVPN? Well, NordVPN will let you have up to 6 devices at once, and it will let you change your country at random. So if you get one of those messages that's saying this video is not playable in your country, with a click of the button, you can simply move your country. Not only that, NordVPN has servers all around the world and they're lightning fast. In addition, you get to use their Android and iOS app for free if you want this service on your mobile device. So if you want 75% off the 3-year plan and 1 month free, you can take a look at the link below. Just make sure you use the coupon code BURA so that they know I sent you. With NordVPN, you can rest assured that your data is safe. If you want to subscribe to all of Mammoth Interactive's courses, you can take a look at the links down below. We have monthly, yearly, and we also have lifetime access. You can also take a look at some of the other products down below. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you in another video.